Welcome to our channel. My name is Caesar, and today we're going to be doing an experiment to show you the differences between diamonds, moissanites, and cubic zirconias. Let's get to it. So we're going to do 11 different things that will tell the difference between diamonds, moissanites, or cubic zirconias. That includes a reading test. It includes a fog test. It includes checking for fluorescence, glass scratch test, the sunlight test. It includes the facet junction test. It includes the diamond tester test, weight versus size, sandpaper, fire test, and then finally, smashing with a hammer. So why do we want to tell the difference between a diamond, a moissanite, and a cubic zirconia? Well, that's easy. The value. Most people want to know if the diamond that they're wearing is even a real diamond, or if they find a diamond, or if they inherit a diamond. Is it real? Diamonds, obviously, are the most valuable. Those things can be worth thousands of dollars. So if you find one, good for you. There are these things called moissanites. Not everybody knows about them, but they are very, very similar to a diamond, and many, many people can get fooled. Now, moissanites were very popular probably about 10 years ago moving forward. It was a great alternative to buying a diamond. They were about 30% cheaper, and actually, they shine brighter than a diamond. CZs, on the other hand, those look like a diamond and can fool a lot of people, but those things are worth almost nothing, and if you get one, just throw it in the trash. The difference between all three of them, of course, is the value. So we're gonna test between a diamond, a moissanite, and a CZ. Okay, so here we go. Our first experiment is the reading test. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take all three stones, put it up, face down, so the top of the stone, which is called the crown, that's gonna be face down, onto a piece of paper with tiny writing on it and see if we can see through it. If we can see through the stone, then it's not a diamond and it's not a moissanite and it's probably a CZ, so you can throw it in the trash. So this is the reading test. Here I have a cubic zirconia, and what you want to do is run it over these small words on a piece of paper, and if you can read through it like this, then it is definitely not a diamond and you can probably throw it in the trash. This is the moissanite. We're gonna run it across these words and see if we can see through it. Looks like you can't, so hang on to this one because it might be a diamond. So now we're testing the diamond on the reading test. Let's run it over these words and see if we can read through it. Looks like we can't. So the reading test looks like CZ, if you can read through it, throw it in the trash. If you can't read through it, hang on to it, because it still might be a diamond. So this next test we're gonna do is the fog test. The way this test works is, we're gonna breathe heavily with our mouths like this. And we're gonna see what happens. If that fog goes away after about a second or two, then it's gonna be either a diamond or a moissanite. If that fog stays there for a little bit longer, then it's a CZ. So we have our three stones. Let's do the fog test. So just like we thought, the CZ fog lasted a few seconds longer than both the diamond and the moissanite. On to the next test. Okay, so this next test is the fluorescence test. What we're gonna do is we're gonna shine a black light on all three stones, and if they glow, then it might tell us if it's a diamond or not. Now, the only problem with this test is that only about 25% of diamonds have fluorescence. They'll glow a bluish color on white diamonds. If it's a different color diamond, it could show a different color fluorescence, but for this test, we're testing if it glows blue. Here we go. Now we're doing the fluorescence test with the CZ, and as you can see with the black light, this one does show a light purple color, but it's still not absorbing it, and you'll see what I mean when we test the diamond. So here we are testing a moissanite with the black light, and what it's doing is, looks like the black light is just shooting right through it. It's not reflecting any of this black light back to us at all. So what you're looking at here are both diamonds. One of them is not fluorescent. It does not absorb any of that blue light. The other one, that's a very strong fluorescence. You can see how bright and blue that is. So from all of our tests, we can see that the stone that didn't reflect any light at all was the moissanite. The CZ reflected a little bit of light. It still wasn't fluorescent. The diamond that we had also reflected a little bit of light, but was not fluorescent. Good thing we had that backup diamond to show you what fluorescence looked like. On to the next test. Next test that we're gonna do is the glass scratch test. Everyone knows that diamonds are one of the hardest minerals on earth, but what about a moissanite and what about a CZ? Are they strong enough to scratch glass? Let's test it out. So after doing the scratch test, it looks like it told us pretty much nothing. They all scratched this glass, the same depth, the same scratchiness. Maybe it's bad glass, I don't know, but if you have one of these stones and you think that the glass test is gonna help you out, it's not. So keep them, don't throw them away yet. Let's go on to the next test. The next test we're gonna do is the sunlight test. Basically, we're gonna take these three stones out in the sun and see how they shine. Most people think, like Rihanna says, you gotta shine bright like a diamond. But actually, a moissanite shines twice as bright as a diamond with double refractiveness. That's right, doubly refractive. So a diamond will show sparkle. Moissanite is actually even sparklier than a diamond. And a CZ has a little bit of shine, but not quite as much. What I want you to do right now is take your diamond outside, put it in the sun, unless you live in Seattle. Sorry guys, there's no sun there. Guys, we're doing 11 tests, and we have 5 down, and we got 6 more to go. This 6th test that we're gonna be doing, you're gonna need some extra tools. This one's gonna require a 10-power loop. This loop is basically just a magnifying glass that magnifies things by 10. So grab yourselves one of these. You can find it on Amazon or eBay or wherever. You look through it, and you'll be able to see what's inside the diamond. What you're gonna be looking for with a 10-power loop is the facet junctions between the stones. Now, what's a facet junction? When a diamond is cut, all the different sides of the diamond is a different facet. Diamond, a round diamond, usually has about 57 facets. When they're cut at a certain angle together. So when those angles meet up, right in between there, that's called the junction. That's called the facet junction. So for a diamond, what you're looking for on the facet junctions, it is a very clear, sharp edge. It is a very sharp edge between the two. There's really nothing in between. It's very sharp, it's very smooth. For a moissanite, moissanites, they can't quite get that sharp of a facet junction. So when you're gonna see when those two facets come together, it's gonna be a little flat. So you're gonna see kind of two edges for every edge of a moissanite. And then for CZs, when you put these two facets together, it is rough, it is rugged, it is not sharp at all. Throw it in the trash. Okay, so this next test is kind of cheating, but we're gonna be using a diamond tester. This diamond tester is a diamondite tester, model is DN1, and there's really only two things on here. It's gonna tell us if it's ready, and when we put this up to the stone that we're testing, it's gonna tell us if it's a diamond. If it beeps green, then it's a diamond. If it shows red under the moissanite, then it's a moissanite. And if it doesn't beep at all, then it's neither one. Okay, great, so our diamond tester worked. The diamonds, it beeped green, the moissanites beep red, and the CZ, nothing happened, just like we thought. So this next test, this is test number 8, and it's really a comparison. Now this one is my favorite because it involves numbers, it involves really the scientific part of measuring, truly measuring all these stones, and that is weight versus size. We're gonna measure each of these stones. We're gonna do the length, the width, and the depth. Multiply that by a number, and that's gonna tell us if it falls within the range of it being a diamond or not. Now, for the way we're gonna test this is, because this is a round diamond, this has a specific number we're gonna multiply this by. If it's a different shape, like a princess cut or a key, whatever, we're gonna multiply it by a different number. So for this test, you're gonna need a couple things. You're gonna need a diamond scale that weighs in carats with a C, and a micrometer. So this is how this test works. We're gonna take the stone, we're gonna multiply the length, the width, and the depth, multiply that by 0.0061, and that number is gonna tell us what that stone should weigh if it's a real diamond. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna take that stone, weigh it on the diamond scale, and compare the two numbers. If those two numbers match up or are very, very close to one another, then we'll be able to tell if it's a diamond. Now, here's something you might not know. A moissanite weighs less by volume, and a CZ weighs more by volume. So that means that if I have three stones, a diamond, a moissanite, and a CZ, that are all the same shape, all the same length, all the same width, all the same depth, they're gonna weigh three different weights. Okay, let's start with the CZ. We're doing the length, 7, the width, 6.99, the depth, 4.23. What does that give us? It gives us a carat weight of 1.26. So that means that if we put this CZ on the scale, and if it is in fact a real diamond, it should weigh around 1.26. In fact, it should weigh maybe even a little bit more. 1.26, probably up to 1.3. maybe 1.35, not much more than that. There's a little bit of variance there, but when we stick it on the scale, it's actually 2.22. This thing weighs about 50% more than it should. So we know just by that, it is 100% not a diamond. So this next one that we're gonna test is the moissanite. When we're doing the length, width, and depth, we got 6.50, 6.51, 3.64. We take that number, multiply it again by 0.0061 because it's a round shape, and that says that our stone, if this is a real diamond, should weigh 0.94 carat, or again, maybe a little bit more because we got a little bit of variance there. So maybe it should be 0.94, 0.95, 0.96, maybe up to 0.98. But in fact, when we stick this thing on the scale, it weighs less. It weighs 0.855. So it weighs about 10% less. And that's a surefire way to let us know that it is a moissanite. It's definitely not a diamond, it's a moissanite. And when you weigh a stone and it's between 10 and 15% less than what your measurements are, that's how you know 100% that it's not a diamond and most likely a moissanite. This last one that we're doing, we're testing the diamond. So length, width, and depth again, 7.43, 7.36, 4.11. Multiply that by 0.0061, and what do we get? We get 1.37 carat. That's what this thing should weigh if it's a real diamond. Let's put it on the scale, and actually 1.36. That is within tolerance. That is very, very, very close, and that's how you'll be able to tell if it's a real diamond. If this thing was anywhere between 1.36, maybe 1.45, somewhere in that range, I would say it passes the diamond test. It's most likely a diamond. Don't always take its word for it because you never know what else is gonna be out there. But for the most part, if it passes this test and passes some of the other ones, most likely it's gonna be a diamond. On to the next test. This next test is gonna be fun. It's a sandpaper test. So we're gonna take all three stones and we're gonna rub them on the sandpaper and see how they hold up. They say diamond's the hardest thing, so it shouldn't be damaged. Let's test the moissanite and let's test the CZ and see what happens. So after running this test, we can see the CZ got totally destroyed on the sandpaper. And surprisingly, the moissanite held up too, and so did the diamond. So if you're scraping it on top of the sandpaper and you see a bunch of scratch marks, most likely it's gonna be a CZ and you know what to do with it. All right, this next test, now we're gonna play with fire!
Fire, 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 fire.
That's my best Beavis impression.
Cool.
So here we go, fire test. Let's light all three of these things on fire. We're gonna put a flame underneath the moissanite, the CZ, and the diamond. We're gonna see what happens. Now, diamonds are 100% carbon. Carbon is the same thing that burns, you know, wood, oil, you know, petroleum. So if we light this thing, technically it could catch on fire. Hopefully it doesn't, because this is an expensive diamond. Let's light it up and see what happens. So to recap the fire test, all it's really gonna tell you is that it might be a diamond, it might be a moissanite, and it's definitely not a CZ. On to the final test. Okay, so for our last experiment, I'm actually kind of nervous about this one because it's the hammer test. We're gonna take a real hammer, smash these stones, and see what happens. You know, I've seen other videos like Dude Perfect, those guys did a great job smashing a diamond, and they swear it did not crack, it did not break. I really hope that happens with us because we got a diamond worth several thousand bucks. I don't want it to break. I've seen videos all over the internet with people smashing diamonds, and these diamonds don't get smashed, but I see diamonds all the time and they're broken. They break, they chip. It's not uncommon for a diamond to break, so hitting with a hammer, I would think that it would still break. Hope that it doesn't, but let's see. My diamond is smashed to pieces. I want to say thanks to the Dude Perfect guys. You guys are the ones who did this experiment before, and you told me it wouldn't break. So I was trying it for myself and ended up smashing a diamond worth several thousand dollars. Thanks a lot. I'll tell you where to send the check. So really, you know, it's a common misconception that diamonds won't break if you smash them with a hammer. I mean, I would say if you had to get to that point where you have a hammer and you're about to smash your diamond to see if it's a diamond, just don't do it. Just, I don't know what you're thinking. Wait, take it to a place that'll test it for you, hopefully for free, and, you know, just save yourself, okay? Don't do it. So I hope you guys had as much fun as I did making this video. I'm still really upset about my multi-thousand dollar diamond being smashed to pieces. But I'll be okay once Dude Perfect sends me my check. Thanks again, guys. If you like this video, like it, subscribe, and check us out in the next video. See you later.